We're seeking change.
Reach out, raise hope, and change society.
Everybody wants good things. We just disagree maybe on how to get there.
The FBI says Flint is one of the most violent cities in the country. Governor Rick Snyder recently unveiled a plan to combat violence there and in other Michigan cities. But a group of Flint residents is already working on the problem. They have formed the Urban Forum for the Prevention of Violence. They're encouraging others to pledge to promote peace. Aaron Dunnigan has been attending the meetings. When he was younger, his parents moved him and his siblings to Flint from Chicago to escape violence. Aaron, what are you trying to do?
Well, we've created a forum, a Violence No More forum, and what we're trying to do, we're trying to bring attention to the violence that's in Flint, that maybe we can get some people who actually care to come in and help us out and give us different things such as jobs and open up some of the community centers and different things like that, that maybe we can get some police and try to limit the amount of crime so that our kids can grow up like most of us did, with the opportunities to play outside.
What made you want to be part of this group?
Well, I've seen the violence. I've even been a part of the violence at one point, and I recognize that even with change, it has to first be an opportunity for change. A lot of people don't get that chance to change because they never see the opportunity to change. And I think that this is what we're allowing people to do, showing them that there is a different way, no matter where you are in life or what you've come from or what you've done, that you still have the opportunity to change your life around and make a difference.
How did you get out?
Well, I mean, for me, it was through my faith in God. I mean, God just really did a number on me. I was locked up. I did 4.5 years locked up when I was 17. So I really had a lot of opportunity to sit down and just spend time talking with God. And he showed me a lot of things that otherwise I would never have seen had I not been in that situation. So I'm still thankful for that. But I want to tell everybody else that you don't have to go that same route. You can make changes now, you know, and I wish that it would have been some type of group that said that back then. And maybe it was, I just wasn't listening. As of right now, we're reaching out to all the ages between 16 to 26 to say, let's make this peace change. Let's show everybody else that we're not just going to sit down and say, okay, this is just what life is, because we hear so many people say that this is just normal for us. And we always say, well, this is not normal, because if you go anywhere else, it's not like that. Like, in the month of January alone, I think it was a murder every other day. Like, I think it was about 12 or 13 murders. That's a murder every other day in a small city as small as Flint. And I think enough is enough.
You said that when you were locked up, you talked to God, and God showed you some things. I'm wondering if you can be a little more specific about that, and what sorts of things did he show you that helped you turn this around?
When I was locked up, you know, I always asked why, you know, and one day I was in my cell and I was getting a new cellmate, and when he came in, you know, I had been reading my word and I had been learning all these new things about God, about him saving us and giving us a different path. And the guy said, I never had the opportunity to talk to nobody that knew anything about God, and I never knew that it was another way other than what I've been doing. And he was younger than me, and I'm like, wow, this is not just me, it's everybody, you know. And right then God showed me that he was going to be able to use me and to be able to tell different people that there's still a change. And, you know, and I was able to say a prayer with him that led him to Christ, and that meant just the world to me, knowing that people can change. You know, people have the desire to change. We just don't know that there is that other side, because growing up in Flint, basically all you see is violence, drugs, guns. That's what you see. That's a basic, like, an everyday life or perspective. And sometimes we can't blame kids for carrying guns or selling drugs when really we don't have any other options, really. Like, there's no jobs and there's no school, and we're closing down all the schools. So there's really no people that can say, you know, I'm going to take the time out to deal with them, because they give up on us the first sign of trouble that we show. And that's why I believe the city is the way it is right now, you know. So we just need people that can say, you know, I'm going to stick it out. I'm going to stay around, and no matter how much consumption of my time it take, I'm going to make sure that we have that option, that other people have that option. And that's all that we're asking for.
Aaron, thank you so much for talking with me today.
Thank you.